everyone. I've got all of my stash out and I thought today we could concentrate on making some journaling cards for our mushroom journal. So I've got loads of little bits and pieces here that I can use to do that with. But first, let me show you the magnificent bird page. I've got that finished now. Ta-da! Here we go. So I used tiny thin washi tapes. I've got a box full of them and I don't really use them for much, but they were perfect for that. I got all the different colours in that I wanted. I put a little mushroom there for him to sit on because I'd made a bit of a hash drawing his legs in. And then I wanted something along the bottom here. And I cut that washi tape in half because I thought it was too broad on its own. And then I made that little sign to put there. I just typed that out and printed it and then copy dyed it and backed it with some of that vintage paper from an old book. So that's that page done. I've been doing a lot of copy dyeing. I've copy dyed that and I've copy dyed the thing that goes, I can't work out which end it goes in now. So I've copy dyed the frame, the back of the frame, and I've copy dyed the back of that card as well. So I think that is one journaling card done. Yay! I've copy dyed the back of this. I can't decide whether I'm going to use that as it is or whether I'm going to cut it up. Whether I'm going to use it as a journaling card just like that or whether I'm going to cut it up so that we can distribute these lovely colours throughout the journal. So that's those two done. I've got all my bits of fabric and tickets and stickers and all sorts in my little tub here that I can use as well. So let's get started. I think I've cut these down. I'm going to use these bigger ones as journaling cards and then the narrower ones I thought I would use as tags. So they can go to one side. We're not making tags today. Maybe we could find a little bird to go on the bottom of there. I have got a bird, a thing of birds here. Has to be the right colour, doesn't it? I like that one. That looks like a swift or a swallow. Let's see, they're small enough, isn't it? I like that one. Okay, we'll ink the edge of the bird. It's too white for... Yeah, it's too... Oh, that's better. Yeah, that's a bit too inked. Don't matter. No, that's definitely better than it was. I like that. Yes, that's much better. Perfect. Yeah, that's fine, isn't it? I like that. Love it, love it, love it. Yeah, that'll be fine. Then we've got... What is this? Well, this is a little notebook that I've made already, look. I inked the inside of the... I coffee dyed the inside of the card and then I popped in some papers. Yeah, that can go over onto there. I've got another one here, I think I did, yeah. Done two of them. But they don't both have to go in the same journal, do they? I've got this, which definitely needs more things on it, doesn't it? It's a bit bare. Right, so maybe the bird. Let's ink her up, or ink him up, and see what we think. Look better when it's a bit too shiny as well, but if you put that ink on it, it just dulls it down a bit, doesn't it? So there's the bird, and then that's about could have a word. Serenity. Oh, that's nice. I like that. Maybe we could do some stenciling on the background. Yeah, let's do that, because it's a bit bare, I think, isn't it? I definitely want those two bits on it in a minute. Right, now the colour. Let's try this distress oxide colour. Bran, we're going with Bran. Oh yeah, that is just what I wanted, love it. Yes, look at that. That's much better. Happy with that. And then we'll put the little birdie on it. And we'll put the serenity on it. Got this lace, so I'm going to cut it in half lengthways because it's too wide. I don't want a massive bow, I just want a little skinny one. This is the right colour though, and I can use the rest of it for something else. There we go, and if we do that into a little, we just really want a tiny bow, not a massive one. Oh yes, use a bit of fabric glue on that to hold it down. I'll just put a little spot of fabric glue there and glue that on. Oh, it's so pretty without being too bright and leery, isn't it? It's busy, but it's not bright and leery. Yeah, I like that. Make a good journaling card and we can write on the back of there. Good. Now then, what's next? This, I wasn't happy with that at all. I was going to cover that completely. So that bit's going to be for journaling. This side we're going to decorate. So I'm going to decorate it with a piece of old paper. I'm going to glue that onto there. These came in the size of, it was not much bigger than a postage stamp that it came in, and I thought, oh, I'll photograph it, enlarge it and print it out on card, but it didn't look right, the colours was wrong and everything, so we didn't carry on with that. So let's just do a bit of glue spreading. And then cut off the edges. that's come out fairly well, hasn't it? Yeah. That's come out fairly well. I'm pleased with that. Now we can decorate this up, can't we? So what we're going to put on here? Got some of our lace left. Have that there. Need to have some kind of mushroom on it, do you think? Do we need to have a mushroom on every single one? Could the lace go that way? Let's see what we've got. Let's have a look at... I've got mushroom like these, which are mushroom stencils. I'd like to use them somewhere. Not sure that this is the right place for it, but... I've got mushroom stamps. I love stamps. I don't know why, but I love stamps. And I have got lots of mushrooms. Got some see-through flowers. Flowers and leaves. Butterflies. That stamp's a bit too bright coloured, isn't it? Well, that one isn't though. Now I've got the butterfly on, I like the look of that. We can edge the butterfly and we can edge the mushrooms if we decide we're going to go with mushrooms. We need a different sticker really, don't we? Yeah, I like that. So let's glue this bit down first. This should be a sticker, I think. I don't know whether anyone else has bought these stickers from... I think I got them from Sheen. It was either Sheen or AliExpress, and good grief, getting the back off is just... almost impossible. It really is awful. It takes ages. Right, where's the fabric glue gone again? We'll glue this down with fabric glue. Just push that on a little bit more and we will snip the ends off it. that's a moth instead of a butterfly. Anyway, it looks good on there. I'm happy with that. What do you think? You probably think I'm a bit crackers. I like that. Yep, I like that one. Pop that somewhere to dry. These are quite like as they are.
I don't think they need any.
If they needed anything, it would be a bit of string around there, do you think? Yeah, I don't... I think for now we'll leave those as they are, because they are just
pretty with just the
butterflies and the mushrooms on them, aren't they? I've got another one of these. I'm going to cover this with like a collage. Look at the state of them, there's stuff everywhere. I'm terrible. That's dry, I'll trim the edges off and I'll just maybe put a mushroom on there. It doesn't have to be a mushroom, does it? It could be a flower this time. I actually think that'll probably just do it, won't it?
I don't think it needs anything else, if I can get that the back off this.
They really do take some getting off later.
The back, you just, honestly, I glued one into my book thinking it wasn't a sticker because it was took me so long and I still never got the back off it.
There we are. I think that's quite busy
enough on its own, isn't it? Quite like that one.
Then we've got this one, which I think is okay and just needs a little bit of something at the bottom here.
So,
that's pretty, isn't it? Let's have a bit of
that on there.
Smooth it out. And then maybe a word or something like that on there, or a stamp. Here we go. Let's try some of this down the edge of there, shall we? Just a little strip of that on the edge. And I'll try and get the back off this. Okay.
something just here. A little bit of something just there. Yeah, that butterfly went a bit skew with there, didn't I? So I'm not going to use that, I'm going to cover it up. There we are, a little pink bird with a pink background. That's okay, we can live with that. And now I'm thinking I want a word. I do like the words. Joy. We'll do that then. There we go. Pretty, pretty, pretty. Yeah. And we've got bees that I think I might cut these in half. Half fish. And then I want to cover the whole of one side, I think. I did. This is what I want, something like this. There we go. Give it a spread the glue. And then we can just stick something in the middle of there. It will either be a bird, a mushroom, or a butterfly. And then, where's my edging gone? Here they are. Here's my really pretty edging. Music paper edging down there. It's really pretty, that music paper edging is. Am I going to pop a little bottom on it? Or a flat back or something like that? What I've got is some little tiny
got is some tiny little, yeah, I'm thinking that. What do you think? I think that'll work. Layla's telling me it's tea time. It's not tea time. Not for another half an hour, but she seems
to think it's just,
she wants her tea now. That little monkey.
It seems that Tallulah agrees with her. Tallulah's shouting as well now. I'm surprised how few butterfly stickers I've got, really. I could do with some more
butterfly stickers. I think that's going to be good. It'll be pretty, won't it?
So I think that's probably enough for today. I'll get some more made and then I'll come back and show you how I do the notebooks as well. So I hope you enjoyed that. Thank you for watching. Bye for now.